Good morning, children. We will study about industries of India. Industries. We have to know one thing that industrial development is lagging behind in the land of India. Very sad, true. More than 70%. More than 70% of the Indians are working in the field of agriculture, that is specialty of India. More than 70%. And some people are working in allied activities of agriculture. They are working in the allied field of agriculture. What is that? Allied field means those fields which are connected with agriculture. Fishing is an allied activity of agriculture. Fishing. Cat rearing is another allied activity of agriculture. Cat rearing. Rearing cattle in the house. This is another allied activity of agriculture. Keeping animals in the house for meat and milk or egg. Some people are keeping some birds for meat and egg. All are parts of agriculture. In short, 70% of the Indians are engaged in the field of agriculture. 70% of the Indians are engaged in the field of agriculture. There is no doubt. Because of these reasons, industrial development is lagging behind in the land of India. Industrial development. But what is that? But during the time of India's 5-year plans, after independence, India adopted 5-year plans. During the time of India's 5-year plans, what happened? During the days of India's 5-year plans, what actually happened? During the time of India's 5-year plans, industrial development happened in the land of India. During the time of India's 5-year plans, industrial development really happened or took place in the land of India. Industrial development happened. Now we have a study about iron and steel industry of India. Iron and steel industry of India. Iron and steel industry is a basic and key industry. That is, iron and steel industry is a basic and key industry. What is the meaning of basic and key industry that we have to know clearly? Basic and key industry. Basic and key industry means those industries which are basic to the nation. They are providing base to other industries. In order to start basic and key industry, we have to spend more money. There are so many other industries. Small scale industries are there. In order to start small scale industries, we have to spend only a small amount of money. In the case of Kota industries, what is the meaning of Kota industries? Kota industries are those industries which are working in the cottage or inside the house. For that also small amount is enough. But what is that? Iron and steel industry is not a small industry. It is a basic and key industry. Basic and key industry. from ancient period onwards or from older time onwards, what happened? People of India were able to understand the process of making iron or iron metals. Metal. Metharoli pillar inscriptions are Metharoli. Metharoli is the name of the place. Metharoli. They are one pillar inscriptions, a pillar. Iron pillar inscriptions there. About this, you had studied in your lower classes. I only told you about Metharoli pillar inscription in your 7th class. I told you. In your 8th class also, I told you. In Metharoli, a very big pillar inscription is there in Metharoli. A very big pillar inscription is there in Metharoli. In the inscription, what is there? So many details about the ancient India is there. So many information, so many details about ancient India is there in this inscription. So many inscriptions. So many things are there in this inscription. Metharoli pillar inscription. Then what is that? This was made of iron piece. So what is the meaning of this one? This shows that. What is the meaning? This shows that from ancient period onwards, in the land of India, what is that? Indian people are able to know about how to process iron items. During 1874, what happened? During 1874 period, in West Bengal, one place is known as Kulti. In that place, the first iron and steel industry was made or established. In a place known as Kulti, the first iron and steel industry was made. But the real foundation of iron and steel industry was made during 1917. During 1907 period, J.N. Tata Tata, Jamshedji Tata, started the first iron and steel industry in the land of Jamshedpur. During 1907 period, the first iron and steel industry was established in the land of Jamshedpur by Tata, Jamshedji Tata. Actually, this was a private sector industry, private sector. And with the establishment of Tata Iron and Steel Company in India, industrial development or industrial production began to develop in the land of India. Industrial production of iron and steel weapons and equipments started in a massive scale in the land of India. That is about iron and steel industry. What I told you? We are studying about industries of India. We are studying about, we are learning about industries of India. We are learning about Indian industries. Then what is that? About 70% of the Indian people are engaged in the field of agriculture. 70%. That means India is basically an agricultural country, India. It is basically an agricultural country. Only some other people are engaged in the field of industry, trade, commerce, etc. So, more than 70% of Indians are in the field of agriculture. And some people are engaged in other allied activities of agriculture. Those activities which are connected with agriculture are there. Fishing, catching fishes, is another activity that is connected with the agriculture. And cattle rearing is another activity that is connected with agriculture. Keeping birds in the house for egg or for meat is another activity that is connected with the agriculture. So what is more than 70% of Indians are there in the field of agriculture. More than 70. So in the case of industrial development, India is lagging behind. Industrial development did not happen in the land of India, but after independence, we know that in 1947 we got independence. After independence, what happened? After independence, independent government of India started to develop industries through 5-year plans. Through our 5-year plans, independent government of India started to provide encouragement to the industrial field of India. Some industries were established here in private field and public field. Now, industrial development of India is going on very speedily than it was before so many years. Industrial development of India is going on in the land of India now. During ancient period onwards, Indian people were aware of the process of iron. Mehrauli Pilla inscription, sir, Mehrauli. In Mehrauli Pilla inscription, so many details are there regarding ancient India. In Mehrauli Pilla inscription, so many inscriptions or descriptions are there regarding ancient India. This Mehrauli Pilla is made out of iron. That shows that Indians know about which one? The process of iron. During 1874, in a place known as Kulti in West Bengal, the first iron and steel industry was established in India. But during 1907 period, the first scientific iron and steel industry was established in the land of Jamshedpur by Tata. With the establishment of Jamshedpur Tata iron and steel industry, what happened? Indians were able to understand the meaning of iron and steel industry. From this day, from this time onwards, Indians were able to understand the meaning of iron and steel industry. Now we have to know what are the necessities of starting iron and steel industry. What are the necessary conditions which we want when starting an iron and steel industry, how many necessary conditions you want, or what are the necessary conditions which we want when we are starting an iron and steel industry? First one is raw material supply. What are the necessary conditions which we want when we are starting an iron and steel industry? First one is supply of raw materials. Raw materials are a must. Raw materials are a must for each and every industry. Raw materials. Raw materials are a must when we are starting an industry. Without raw materials, we cannot start any industry without raw materials. Nobody can start an industry without raw materials. Now in the land of Mudodi, you might have seen so many sugar industries are there. In the land of India, in the land of Mudodi, we do have so many sugar industries. What is the raw material of sugar industry? You know better than me. What is the raw material of sugar industry? You know it. Sugar cane is the raw material of sugar industry. Sugar cane. So what is that? Sugar cane is the raw material of sugar industry. Without sugar cane, sugar industry cannot function clearly. Sugar cane is a must for the sugar industry. Sugar cane. Sugar cane is very important for the sugar industries of India. It is a must. Sugar cane is a must for the sugar industry of India. Sugar cane. Then what is that? Just like that, in the case of iron and steel industry, what is that? For iron and steel industry also, raw material is a must. So, where there are enough raw materials, there only iron and steel industry can be located. So, for iron and steel industry, what do you want? For iron and steel industry, we want correct or clear supply of raw materials. Without correct or clear supply of raw materials, no industries can function clearly. So, for the function of iron and steel industry, correct and clear and abundant supply of raw materials are a must. Coal. Cooking coal is the energy. Cooking coal is the energy which we are using inside iron and steel industries. Without coal, what is that? Without coal, iron and steel industries cannot be functioned easily and smoothly. So, a clear supply of cooking coal or coal is a must for all the iron and steel industries of India. The railway transport. Railway. What does it mean? Railway transport is a must for iron and steel industries. In order to bring raw materials from far away places, they want railway transport. And in order to send out, what is that? In order to send out finished goods in far away places also, they want what they want? They want railway transport. So, iron and railway transport facilities are there. So development of railway is a must for the development of iron and steel industries. Then port. What is that? A well-developed port is a must for the development of iron and steel industries. Port. A well-developed port is a must for the development of iron and steel industries of Nepal. Because raw materials reach in the port through ship. And from the port, by using lorry or other vehicles, they can carry raw materials to the industries and send out finished iron and steel to foreign countries also they are on the port. So the development of port, development of port is a must for the development of iron and steel industries. Water facilities. Water facilities are a must. Water facilities are a must for the development of industries. So, for industrial development, what is that? For industrial development, more water facilities are a must. Without enough water facilities, iron and steel industries will not function smoothly. Therefore, labor, what is it? Cheap and abundant supply of labor, cheap, is a must for the development of iron and steel industries. The labor should be skilled enough to work in the iron and steel industries. They should be skilled enough to work in the industries. They should have skill. Then what is it? And their wage level should be small. Their wage or wage level should be small also. Cheap and abundant labor supply is a must for the development of iron and steel industries. Capital. Capital, money. What is the meaning? Capital or money is a must for the development of iron and steel industries. What is the meaning of capital? That I have told you children more than 1000 million crore time I have told you. What is capital? Capital is the basic money. Capital. Capital is a basic money that is necessary to run a business or an economic activity. Basic money. The basic money which we want to run any economic activity is known as capital. That is money. Without money, no industries will develop. For the development of industries, what is necessary? For the development of industries, we want capital. So capital is very important for the development of industries. Capital. For the development of industries, we want capital. So, in order to develop iron and steel industry mainly, we want capital. So, capital should be available to the iron and steel industries at a cheaper rate of interest market. Market is a must. Market. Market is a must. A very good market is a must for the development of industries market. Without a market, iron and steel items cannot be sold out. That is the essential market. These are the basic facilities which are necessary for the development of iron and steel industries of India. Now in the land of India, 14 iron and steel industries are there. 10 are in public sector and 4 are in private field. What is that? Now 14 iron and steel plants are there in India. Out of 14 plants, 10 are in public field and 4 are in private field. Other than very big industries, what is that? Other than very big iron and steel industries, 199 mini steel plants are there in the land of India. 199 mini steel plants are there in the land of India. In the production of iron and steel, India ranks 8th place. In the production of iron and steel, what is that? India plays 4th place in the world. That is about iron and steel industry of India. Iron and steel industry of India. Then what is that? There are so many basic facilities, or so many basic facilities are necessary for the functioning of, for the development of iron and steel industries. What are the basic facilities? What are the basic facilities which are necessary for the function of iron and steel industry of India that we are studying? What are the basic facilities which are necessary for the functioning of iron and steel industry of India that we are needing? First one, raw materials. Cheap and abundant supply of raw materials are a must for the development of iron and steel industry. All the industries of India, what they want? All the industries of India want? What they want? All the industries of India want, what they want? Raw materials, kaccha vastuga. Without raw materials, no industry can function smoothly. Like that, iron and steel industry of India want cheap and abundant supply of raw materials. Without cheap and abundant supply of raw materials, no industry of India will develop. So, like that, iron and steel industry of India is in need of cheap and abundant supply of raw materials. Where there is a presence of cheap and abundant raw materials, industries or iron and steel industries will develop. Cooking coal. Coal is the raw material. Cooking coal is the raw material which we are using in the iron and steel industries. So, for the development of iron and steel industries, enough cooking coal is a must. Where there is a presence of enough cooking coal, there iron and steel industries will develop. Railway system. A well-developed railway system is a must for the development of iron and steel industries of India. A well-developed railway system is a must for the development of iron and steel industries of India. A well-developed railway system is a must for the development of iron and steel industry of India. Port is a place where ships are coming. A well-developed port facility is a must for the development of iron and steel industry of India. Water facility. Iron and steel industries are made of water facility for the development. Without water facility, no iron and steel industry will not develop. So, water facility is a must for the development of iron and steel industry. Labor. Cheap and abundant labor is a must for the development of iron and steel industry of India. Capital, basic money. The basic money which we want to start an economic activity, that is known as capital. Cheap and abundant capital is a must for the starting of iron and steel industry in the land of India. Market. What is the meaning of this one? Market, a very good market or a well developed market is important. A well developed market is a must for the development of iron and steel industry of India. In the land of India, 14 iron and steel industries are there in the land of India. 14 iron and steel industries are there in the land of India. 14. And out of the 14 iron and steel industries, 4 are in private field and 10 are there in government field. Other than very big industries, 199 small iron and steel plants are there in the land of India. In the production of iron and steel equipments and weapons, India ranks 4th place in the world. Dear children, you observe this video, read the same topic in the textbook. If you do have doubts, you call me in.